Hello, Mr. Towsey. How are you today?
Oh, I'm all right.
We're going to take you around to the accessible stop there, sir, and drop you off, okay?
No, actually, you're not going to move this bus because the police told me to wait here until they show up.
Well?
And I told the driver, if you keep driving this bus without letting me off at that platform, then you're kidnapping
sir,
me.
Sir, we're not, we can't allow you off this platform. You're aware.
Well, that's all right. That's, I'm recording everything you're saying.
Yes, sir. And
CTV
and
News is on their way. So is the police, okay. Right?
Yes, sir. And I realize that.
Well, you know what?
Mr. Towsey,
I have my rights.
Yes,
I have my rights.
Do.
I was sitting at that platform. This is an accessible bus. That's a perfectly acceptable, accessible bus platform.
No, sir.
Yes, it is, because the Pinhorn one's much worse than this one, okay?
No, sir.
I've been on that platform in my wheelchair. I've had buses let me off on this platform before, okay? And I don't care what you say. You're violating my human rights. You want no.
Sir.
This is going to happen today, okay? This
sir,
is,
you know what?
I've been reasonable with you guys since I got in a wheelchair. Metro Transit has, and the Human Rights Commission has, my well-written human rights complaint against you people and your operation. And they've been investigating that now for 6 months, okay? You think you're gonna bury that? You're not.
That platform
is accessible for wheelchairs. The minimum you gotta do is at the other end to change the end. Listen, I'm gonna talk. The minimum you gotta do at the other end is, I'm gonna talk because I'm recording all this, okay?
No,
you see?
No,
I'm not gonna listen to you. I'm not gonna listen to you. Okay, it's not about
you're
you.
You're not going to listen to me.
That's right. I'm going to wait for the police like I told you.
All right. Mr. Towsey, we're just trying to get you off the bus.
It's okay. It's too late for that, okay? I'm sick and tired of being treated like a piece of garbage. I sat on Portland Street for 45 minutes waiting for this bus. Every single other bus went by, and they're not designated as wheelchair routes, and they wouldn't let me on. All I wanted to do was go to the sports flex, right? So, no, it's not understandable to anybody because I'm the only person that's being discriminated against because I'm in a wheelchair. Anybody else standing at a bus stop that wants to get out of a bus is not refused. You have no right to refuse me either, okay? And this excuse that it's going to be a designated wheelchair route, that's a bunch of crock because I've already talked to all the drivers and the designated wheelchair routes, at least a third of the bus stops on those routes, are not accessible.
And right now we're identifying more stops, so we're able to...
It doesn't matter what you're doing and not doing. You have no right to tell me I cannot get on a bus, and you have no right to tell me I cannot get off a bus.
That
platform is perfectly safe for a bus to unload a wheelchair. Okay? That's it.
So you wanted to originally get off down by the sports bus.
And I missed my stop because I didn't pull the bell. It doesn't matter. I told him as he was only a few feet away from the stop.
What's the problem right now if we took you around there and...
You know what started all this? Is because he said he was going to drive me to Halifax. He said he wasn't going to turn around. He wasn't going to let me off the bus. He said he's taking me to Halifax. And I said, no, I'm not going to Halifax.
You want to get off the sports bus. I understand that.
If he had said to me, if he had been reasonable and said I'll turn around and I'll let you off. If he had said that, I would have been fine with me. He said he's taking me to Halifax. I said, no, you're not. Because once you go beyond this point, you are kidnapping me. Because he was stopped at the shelf, at the platform right there. And I don't care about all your reasoning at Metro Transit. I don't care anymore.
I'm not trying to reason. I'm trying to help you out right now.
You're not helping me at all because you people could ignore everything I've ever said in the past.
So
I've written all this out. It's all legal. It's published online too. The world can read it. I have websites that it's on.
So
everybody knows what's been going on. And you people are ignoring everything.
I have this bus turned around and drop you off.
That's too late now because when he told me he wasn't going to let me off the bus.
He needs permission.
When he told me he wasn't. No, I asked him, are you going to call head office? He said no. He said, I'm going to drive you to Halifax. That's when I called the police. And when I called the police, they told me to wait here. They said, don't get off the bus and wait. They are on their way, and so is CTV News, because CTV News is very aware of all this.
Yes.
And my human rights complaint that Metro Transit has decided to bury, which is against the law, is going to blow up in their face today. I had enough of this.
We're just going to move HRP, and they told us it's okay for us to move the bus around with the accessible stuff.
Okay.
You can move it there, but I'm not getting off until I talk to them.
You got to go around with us, or you're going to just meet us here?
Down there.
Okay. Steve?
I've been to your public hearings. I've done it all. I've done all the legal stuff. I've done all the paperwork, and you people don't do anything to make any changes, and you keep ignoring intelligent people like me. Well, you know what? I'm not a piece of garbage.
Nobody said you were.
Well, I'm being treated that way by Metro Transit.
Has anyone here treated you that way today?
He was stopped at the concrete slab. He could have let me off. There was nobody standing in front of the bus. The
problem is he's following No.
That's right. He's following Metro Transit's stupid rules because they're a bunch of idiots managing Metro Transit. Metro Transit thinks they're going to keep treating me like a piece of garbage. I have the same rights as everyone else. They can get off at that bus stop. I want to get off there too. You have no right to tell me I can't. That's what it comes down to.
Yeah, you don't have to raise your voice.
No, I don't breathe well, so when I get talking, that's the way I breathe. That's the way I talk. My whole rib cage is crushed, so I can't move my lungs when I'm talking. That's why I'm loud.
Mr. Rouse, are you the gentleman that had the variance for the...
Yes, I do. Yeah. That was another big fight with you guys. Couldn't believe it. All this has got to stop with you guys. All your excuses, I'm sick and tired of hearing them all. I'm not a stupid person. I ran a billion-dollar company. I ran all kinds of companies. I know how to think.
I'm what? But who's calling you stupid?
One second. Hi, Rick. They're moving the bus. I'm going up the street, and I guess they're taking me to the front of the sports flags, but I'm not getting off this bus because the police told me to wait for them. Okay, I was just talking with Rick Grant. And he said he's sending a crew down. But anyway, let him know that I'm in that guy in the wheelchair that's going for a drive around the city here. They're going all the way around the neighborhood to go to a stop in front of the sports place. Then I was told by the police to stay in the bus and wait for them. And now the bus is moving, even though they were told that the police were already on their way. Well, I haven't called the police back to tell them that the bus is moving, but that's okay. They'll figure it out.
Heard it up.
Well, are you guys sending somebody down? Well, you know what? You may as well, because I'm in a wheelchair, and there's no paddy wagons that can take wheelchairs. They can't take me out of this chair because I've got a broken back and a lot of other serious injuries. And you guys better do this story because I'm sick and tired of being ignored by everybody. I have a human rights complaint filed against Metro Transit, and they've ignored it now for 6 months. Okay, this has got to come to the public's attention, because the public's got to know that Metro Transit discriminates against people in wheelchairs. I mean, it's really, really bad. It's much worse than anything you can imagine. And I'm tired of being treated like a piece of garbage. But you know, when that driver told me he wasn't going to let me off at the bridge terminal, when he was sitting right at the bridge terminal, at the concrete slab, and anybody else who's not in a wheelchair wants to get off a bus is not refused, and he told me he's going to drive me to Halifax, and I said, I don't want to go to Halifax, and he wouldn't let me off the bus. If that's not a news story for you, I don't know what is. Do you know of anybody else that's being told they can't get off a bus when they want to? So Metro Transit and all the stupid policies and everything, I don't care. I've had enough of all that. I've done it all legal. I filed all the paperwork. It's all done. You've got a huge story sitting right here. Please do the story. Thank you very much. Daniel Towsey. Towsey. Anyway, I'll be in front of the sports bike sitting in this bus. Thank you. Bye-bye. So either you guys are going to try to arrest me and put me in jail. Like, I'm not talking to the guy on the phone right now. I'm talking to you guys, right? I'm not getting off this. I know, but I'm not getting off this bus until I get off where I wanted to get off.
I always ask you to get off the bus.
We're not going to arrest you, sir. That's not up to us.
That's right. The police can't arrest me either, because especially with my human rights complaint against you people. You would look pretty bad. You're denying me the same rights everybody else has, and that's what my human rights complaint is about. And I don't care how about the stupid idiots at Metro Transit that think they know everything. And lying to people, the public, and saying that bus stop station up there is not accessible to wheelchairs, that's not true. It's much better than the one at Penhorn. You see this bus shelter right here? You see how bad Metro Transit is? See this? They've got a number on this from almost a year ago where I asked them to put a concrete slab on the other side so that when I'm waiting for a bus, the buses can see me. Right? I can't sit on the sidewalk and block the sidewalk. When I pull up behind that sign, I can't see the buses coming, and they can't see me. Oh, they told me, I called up on the reference number, and they said, oh, the ground's frozen. Oh, we'll have to wait. And they still haven't done it. It's the same thing with the one across the street.
Well, unfortunately, we don't look after
them. It's the same thing with the one across. Yeah, but I keep hearing excuses all the time, but they don't do that for anybody else. I'll tell you, anybody who's able-bodied, okay, you violate their rights. It's done like that. Why is people in wheelchairs being treated any different? I have the same rights as everyone else.
Absolutely.
How much work would it take to put a concrete slab on that side, and how much work would it take to take that door that's on the street side and put it on the other side?
To your service request on that?
They're not doing any. Look, I can give you all the reference numbers to all these different issues, and not one thing's been taken care of, ever, ever. And I've called the call center, and I've told them, I said, I've got the reference. I've talked to the mayor about this. I've talked to a lot of people. I have the reference numbers. I followed up on it. I did everything legal, and I did everything right. It's all itemized. It's all done. And the people at Metro Transit who are managing transit should be fired because they're criminally negligent for what they're doing. And just remember, okay, my camera's still recording everything.
Yeah, That's fine. I'm here.
No, it's not about you. That's why I haven't put the camera on your face. It's not about you. It's just about Metro Transit's policies against people in wheelchairs. And believe me, I've talked to a lot of people in wheelchairs, and they've all got the same problems, and they're all happy I'm doing this. And if I go and talk to my friends, I can have a big protest done. I told the inspector, when I was sitting here on that side of the street on a cold day, before March, when I first got my chair, it was really cold outside. I had left here doing physiotherapy. I went across the street, and I sat there for 4.5 hours. Buses kept driving by me and wouldn't stop. Even the ones that were wheelchair routes wouldn't stop for me. I sat there, I was shivering so bad I couldn't take the cold anymore. I called Metro Transit and I told them, I said, why aren't your drivers stopping for me? Finally, I got a woman that walked by on the sidewalk and I asked her, can you please get on the street and stop this bus for me? She blocked the bus on the middle of the street. The bus driver pulls over and says, I can't let you on this bus. And I said, why not? She said, because it's full. And that's what happens when I sit on that side of the street. Besides of having that sign blocking me, the buses coming out of the terminal are all full. Well, you know what? This is the day that my rights are going to stop being violated. I'm telling you, man, I'm the strongest person you'll ever meet. I have had enough of all this. Because Metro Transit is being stupid and ignorant, and they need to be fired. There's no reason in the world why they couldn't have taken that sign down, which I asked them to do, so the buses can see me. Or put a platform in. You know what? The excuses are over.
I can't deal with your past complaints right now. We're here
to... I'm going to deal with all of it right now because I've had enough of all of this, okay? I've had enough.
We're here to help.
No, right no. You guys, here. I've heard that line so many times.
Okay, Mr. Towsey, are you going to exit the bus right now?
I'm waiting for the police as I was instructed by the police.
Because that's our next step is we have to call...
The police asked me to wait for them.
Okay, well, now we have to... Apparently, according to the police, they aren't responding when we talk to them. So now we're going to have to make the call to them.
Okay, call them.
And we'll escalate it up and we'll ask
for
the fee to come. Okay, sir?
Rick, I called you, I called back, and I spoke to your dispatcher over the other person that was there. When I was at the bus terminal, the police advised me to wait in the bus for them because they were coming. Now Metro Transit drove the bus around to another bus stop and are claiming that they want me to get off the bus, and I told them that the police advised me to wait. The police never called me back telling me that I should get off the bus. Now they're telling me, the Metro Transit is telling me that they're going to call the police because they were told that the police is not coming. So you tell me why it is that the police tell me to wait on a bus and then Metro Transit tells me that the police is not coming. Anyway, I'm going to call 911 now and find out what's going on. But you know, maybe you guys will do your news story for a change.